Terrence is grody as fuck, so just stop, please, before I throw up.
I thought you were like his secret lover.
Yeah, right. He wishes I was his secret lover. He probably has a shrine of me or some shit in his room.
So you don't feel a little bad for the guy?
Why should I feel bad? All I said to the guy was fuck off and die. At least now he might get the point.
I don't know. Probably still madly in love with you. Even if he did totally embarrass the fuck out that nigga today.
Oh, whatever. He totally embarrassed himself. Anyway, I thought we were talking about cute guys, not Corey Terrence. You're totally killing my boner right now.
Morgan, I heard that. Get off the phone right now.
Do you ever knock or what?
Not in my own house, I don't. Now get off.
Daddy, it's Gina Rice.
I don't care if it's Jesus Christ. Hang it up.
Hey, boo, I gotta go. My dad just rolled in here like the fucking Calvary.
OMG.
Yeah, I'll call you later.
No, you won't.
What is your deal?
The deal is you're grounded, young lady. Now, what is it about that you don't seem to understand?
I understand fine, okay? Don't treat me like I'm fucking five.
Then don't act like it. And watch your language, all right? At your age, if I was to cuss at my dad the way you do, he'd have beat the shit out of me.
That's because he was a manic depressive alcoholic.
Enough! No more of this smart-ass shit, all right?
All right! Jeez Louise, talk about cussing. You should wash your mouth out with soap.
Oh, Morgan, I don't know what I'm gonna do with you.
Well, you could start with ungrounding me.
Yeah, I don't think so.
This is so not fair.
No, what's unfair is what I caught you doing in my house while I was gone. And if your mother was alive, she'd say the same thing.
Well, she's not. So don't rub that one in my face, okay?
Look, I'm running late enough as it is. What I need
for
you to
do... Where are you
going? Out, to dinner.
With who?
Who do you think?
Not Bryn.
Yes, of course, Bryn.
Oh, gag me.
I don't understand you, Morgan. What is your problem with her?
Nothing except for the fact that she's a steaming pile of bitch. She's totally fake.
Well, like it or not, honey, that fake pile of bitch just might be your stepmother one day.
And I will fling myself off the balcony. I swear I'll do it.
I don't have time for this. I gotta go. Did you give Grandma her pills yet?
Sorry.
Sweetheart, I've told you a million times it's imperative she take those pills.
Where the hell is LaRosa?
I gave her the weekend off. Besides, it's not her job to take care of her.
Why, all of a sudden, is it my responsibility? Can we not, like, hire somebody to take care of her?
Do you want to pay for it? I didn't think so. Now look, I'm going to be gone till about midnight, so be sure to take real good care of Grandma, all right?
Fine. You're going to be late for Bryn.
Oh, and no boys, Morgan. I mean it. I better not catch that little boy toy of yours creeping around my house anymore. We clear?
Totes, Daddy. Better go now. Don't want to keep Miss Bryn waiting.
Thank you. David McKenzie's office. Hello? Can I help you? I forgot to give you your pills, I know, but I'm gonna bring them to you, okay?
I can already feel my insides failing me now.
Your pills are gonna make you feel better, Grandma. But you gotta eat something before I can give them to you, okay?
I heard a phone ring downstairs.
I know. I'm sorry. I don't know who it was. So, did you want something?
Cheese dip soup. Something hot. Something wet. My colon feels like it's all blocked up.
I don't know if we have any such thing as cheese dip soup, Grandma. Even if we did, I don't think it's gonna help your colon any.
You just make it for me. And fix me some coffee, too, while you're at it.
Fine. I'll do it. But before you get any sicker, you may want to think about putting some more clothes on, Grandma.
You should think about putting on more clothes, dear.
Grandma, what are you doing?
You're not still dressing up like a little harlot, are you?
Let me go!
Harlot. She brings nothing but chaos and disorder. She carries it like a plague.
Let me go! To go get the soup. And the coffee too, remember?
Make it fast, dear. It gets so lonely up here.
So dreadfully lonely.
Thank you. Mother, you're dead.
I'm here all the time. With you, with Daddy, with Grandma upstairs. Everywhere. Forever and always.
Please don't do this to me.
Oh, honey. I'm afraid you do this to yourself.
Stop it! You've been dead for over a year now.
Why do you keep saying that? I could never leave you. Never.
Nothing did you this. Just talk to me! I want to know what happened by the pool, Mother.
What are you frightened of, dear?
Nothing. I saw the window was open. I don't know.
Did you think I jumped out?
What were you doing, Grandma?
Well, I had to go really bad.
That is disgusting.
I got tired of ringing the bell. I had to go, and so I went.
I didn't hear you ring a bell.
I rung it for a long, long time.
Motherfucking smoke alarm, I swear to God.
You really ought to come quick when I ring the bell, hun.
I told you I didn't hear a bell. I was making goddamn cheese dip soup, whatever the fuck that is, and I fucked it up the first time, so I had to make it the second time, and now it's ruined.
Oh, no, it isn't, dear. It's not. Not yet, it's not.
Yes, it is. Everything is so fucked right now.
Oh, no, everything's fine, dear. You see? Look, Let me just show you here. It's gonna be okay. Look.
Grandma, what are you doing? Stop!
You see? It's good. It's fine. I'm eating.
stay down there for all I care. I gotta go get something to clean this up.
It ain't as bad as it seems.
Whatever. Just promise me, for the love of God, you're not gonna lap up what's in the closet over there.
Is everything good here, Mr. McKenzie?
Wonderful, Alexandra. Thank you.
Excuse me. This sushi tastes like a bottom feeding catfish. Get it out of here, please. And bring us another bottle of wine whenever you can fit it in.
Absolutely, ma'am. I am so sorry about that.
Don't apologize.
Is there anything else I can get for you, sir?
We're fine. As many times as we've come here, you would think that they would not forget the bloody wine.
I know. Look, sweetheart, is everything all right? You seem a little agitated.
It's nothing. Sometimes I just wish my goddamn ex-husband would go ahead and broke. Bastard.
Oh, no. What did he do this time?
Well, the son of a bitch is trying to hit me up again for more child support, as if he hadn't already bled me dry. We allowed to smoke in here?
Of course not. Come on.
Christ on his throne.
I don't see why you don't just go ahead and fight for full custody.
Have you ever met my daughter, David? The little heathen doesn't deserve a mother.
Oh, come on, Bryn. Every girl deserves a mother. Shit. As spoiled as my daughter is, she sure could use a mother's influence right now.
You don't think you can handle her?
No, I do. It's just she doesn't ever want to listen to me.
So I've heard.
You know, when Diana was alive, Morgan used to do everything I said. Or everything she said, at least. I don't know. Things were just different back then.
You might just need to face the facts, David, that your wife is dead, and that she's going to have to start facing the future very soon. It can be frightening for young girls of her age, but also very necessary.
Yeah, she just lacks guidance.
Oh, I think it's discipline she lacks, David, not guidance. I mean, let's face it, she continues to act out without the slightest bit of concern for the consequences.
She's just confused, that's all.
Well, I realize she's your daughter. But I can't help but feel the reason she's so wayward lately, because you're not seeing each other.
Oh, I think it's a lot of things, actually. But you know, tonight I came out and told her I was taking you out to dinner, no ifs, ands, or buts.
And what does she have to say about that?
I think she was okay with it. Actually, I think she's starting to get used to the idea of you being around a lot more, so.
Well, good, because I told the little darling one day that I was going to be a very huge part of her life. Whether she liked it or not. You just have to be firm with kids these days, as hard as it may seem.
You're absolutely right. I feel like I've been laying down the law a lot more, though, here lately. It's just she's so damn bullheaded sometimes.
She's like her father. In all seriousness, though, David, you've been extremely lenient on her. You're much more tolerant than I am. If it had been me who'd caught my daughter going down on her boyfriend in my jacuzzi, well, I probably would have strangled her to death.
I know, trust me. I'm trying to get it all off my mind right now, you know?
Yes, well, I can imagine a sight such as that sticking in the back of your mind.
Exactly. It's just weird. I mean, every time I look at her, that's all I see now. Her doing that.
In that case, I might have an idea. Perhaps there's something I could do to help you get it off the line.
Girl, don't even lie. Seeing what you were doing there. Having fantasies about me or what?
Fuck no. Get over yourself.
You look so fucking hot right now.
Well, you don't, so fuck off.
Damn. You're in a weird ass mood tonight, aren't you?
You're the weird ass dude creeping on me like that?
I tried to call you like 100 fucking times. You didn't answer.
I know. My dad has my phone. You better not have sent me any nasty shit either. He's probably going through it right now.
No way. This dude's a fucking Looney Tune. I like how he wrote in blood red letters.
Ew, I don't. Fucking wigs me out.
My dearest Morgan, I sit and look at you in study hall and I'm constantly reminded of how much beauty there truly is in my dark, lonely world. When I see your silky blonde hair, it brightens up my darkest day. I always think of a fire burning in a snowy log cabin. Really?
Keep reading. Gets better.
Sometimes I just want to hold on to you forever and never let you go. I've thought of ways to try to tell you this, but I don't want to come off as some kind of jerk who doesn't know what love really is. Does this dude want me to pound his fat ass or what?
Read what it says at the bottom.
I'm tired of always trying to find ways to express myself to you. I feel like the reason you always avoid me is because deep down you're afraid to confront your true feelings about me. I'm tired of this dude thinking he's some kind of poet. That's what I'm tired of.
Read what he says at the end. He's fucking psycho.
I feel like if you don't go out with me real soon, I'm gonna have to explode. You wouldn't want that, would you? I feel I would squeeze you so tight while you looked into my eyes. Squeeze you tight under the moonlight until you changed your mind. Under my control, you would finally find out what a great guy I truly am. You would definitely see me as husband material. Or at least I hope you would. Anyway, I hope you would make up your mind real soon on whether or not you want to be with me. After all, I would seriously hate it if the only way that we could ever be together is if we died together.
Pretty fucked up, right?
Has anyone else read this?
No. Why?
There's a fucking death threat, girl.
What?
This motherfucker's threatening your life. I know it.
Shut up.
Hell no. This shit's serious. That letter's got death written all over it.
Dude, shut the fuck up. It's not funny.
I'm not trying to be funny. That dude's got a serious problem, for real. Did you even read what he said? He said he wanted for you and him to die together.
I know! I know what the letter says, okay? And if you're gonna keep scaring me all night, you can leave the same damn way you came in.
Look, I'm just saying. Dude's nutty as fuck, man. I wouldn't put shit past him.
All right, okay. I'm over it. I'm done talking about Corey Terrence.
Oh, you can't just ignore shit like that, Morgan.
I'm not ignoring anything.
look here, fucker. You need to quit fucking around and harassing me, okay?
Who is that?
This fucking loser keeps calling me and won't leave me alone.
What the fuck's he saying? What'd you just say, chump? Who the fuck is this? Oh, so now you're not gonna say shit. Well, if you dial this number again, man, you're gonna get your ass beat, all right?
What'd he say?
Nothing. Not a damn thing. Why don't you just take that shit off the hook?
It's my dad's work line.
Who gives a shit?
He does. He'd fucking kill me.
How many times has this asshole called you?
I don't know. Doesn't really matter, okay? It just fucking pisses me off. He's gotta know who I am, too.
How do you know that?
Because he knows my dad's work number, and I heard him shouting my name while he was blowing his wad, so...
No fucking way. Has it even occurred to you at all that it could possibly be Corey Terrence making all these calls?
Of course it has. And maybe it is, but maybe I don't want to know.
Well, what are you gonna do if he keeps calling back?
Fuck it. He won't. Exactly what the fuck you were doing in there.
I didn't know you were gonna freak out like that.
I'm not talking about the salvia, fucktard. I'm talking about you and how you always take shit too far.
Well, look, you're the one who wanted to try it, so don't blame this on me.
You still don't understand what the fuck I'm talking about, do you?
I guess I don't.
In a nutshell, genius, you just took advantage of me, and I don't fucking play like that.
Oh, come on, Morgan. We've done way worse than that, and you never said shit about it before.
Maybe I'm just tired of getting my ass chewed out because of you.
Because of me?
Yeah, dingus. It's your fault I'm on house arrest, remember? It's because of you I can't leave this dungeon.
You can keep blaming me all you want, but I'm tired of listening to it.
Of course you are. You couldn't give less of a shit about how badly my life is fucked right now.
Oh, how is your life fucked?
How is my life fucked? Let's count the ways. My dad took away my Lexus, my tablet, my phone, my music, basically everything that makes me me.
Well, what the hell do you want me to do about that?
I want you to stop dragging me into shit and coming over here thinking you're gonna get something out of it.
I never dragged you into shit.
What did I say to you when you first got here tonight? I told you you weren't getting any. And that's exactly what the fuck I meant. If you can't just hang out and be cool, then maybe we shouldn't hang out at all.
Jesus. What, did you have some kind of, like, religious experience or something?
No. It's not gonna be your fucking whore anymore.
You know, this ain't like you, Morgan. I don't know what it was I did to piss you off so bad. But maybe it'd be best for the both of us if I left. Is that really what you want?
Look, if you're gonna leave, could you at least put the ladder back by the pool house where you found it?
Fuck this shit. What? Who's there?
I've got something to show you.
to do to me? Who is this?
You. It's you, you little sow. It's you I want to be fucked. Not him. Be fucked right now. I hear you loud and clear, but you need to listen to me. That Robbie is up to no good, and I wouldn't put anything past him. Now, I saw some of the text messages he sent to your phone, and I couldn't believe some of the stuff I read.
She went through my phone?
That's right, and it's a good thing I did. I finally found out what kind of boy my daughter associates with so that I can put a stop to it. And don't think I didn't see all those dirty pictures you two sent to each other either.
Daddy, you had no right to do that.
I had every right to do that, young lady. I'm the one who pays that phone bill, remember? So if some pervert keeps calling you being inappropriate, Morgan, it's probably him.
It's not Robbie, Daddy. I know for a fact that it's not.
Well, what the hell else am I supposed to believe after what I saw? Just seeing the two of you together like that, honey, I'm still in a state of shock.
For God's sake, David, what is it?
It's nothing. Just don't have a very good feeling right now.
About what?
About Morgan.
What are you trying to say?
I'm saying, I think we need to go back.
Go back? David, are you out of your mind? What about our ticket?
We can go to the opera another night, all right?
Listen to what you're saying. We drove all the way out here, and you just want to turn around and go back. David, let's not go back. Let's not.
I have to check on Morgan, Bryn. I can't just let her go. God, you don't understand.
I understand that this infatuation with your daughter is becoming extremely unhealthy. That's what I understand.
Look, we're going back and that's all there is to it, all right? I don't care what you have to say.
Thank you. Yes, you do. Barry Pone. I'm a close colleague of your father's.
What do you want?
Look, I know it's late, but I really need to talk to your dad. It's very important.
He's busy right now.
Yeah, I know. He's still at the opera with Brynn. I talked to him just a couple hours ago.
So what are you doing here?
I was told to be here as soon as he got back. I guess I'm just early.
Don't you drive a black Mercedes?
Yes, that's right. See, you know me.
I just didn't see it parked out front.
That's because that German piece of shit just up and died on me about 2 miles up the road. I had to walk through this rain. It just quit.
So you need a tow truck or something? Do you not have a phone?
No. That's taken care of. I was really just hoping I could wait here for him.
So you decided to hike all the way up here in this mess? Are you crazy?
Can you believe I ask myself that a lot lately? No, if I'd have known that it was gonna rain like this, I would have stayed with the car, I promise.
Yeah. Sucks for you.
Like you have no idea. Listen, sweetie, can I just come inside for just 1 second? I just need to dry off. This rain is really cold. Don't know the gate code. The gate's open. Morgan, I can promise you that gate was wide open when I got here. I don't have any reason to lie about that. Look, I know it's late. And I know you don't know me that well, and that this probably sounds like a whole bunch of crap to you, and it's good that you're thinking that way.
Then you can understand why I can't let you in here.
Yeah. I suppose I can understand why you feel that way. Listen, I'm gonna go ahead and go. And, I'm sorry I scared you, Morgan, okay? And have a good night.
Thank you. Oh man, I'm getting the floor all wet.
It's fine. I was gonna go get some towels anyway.
I'm really sorry about dropping in on you like this. I must have scared the crap out of you, huh?
It's fine. Been jumpy all night anyway. Storm isn't really helping.
Well, I mean it's got to be scary, right? I mean, a big house like this, all by yourself.
Yeah. And I mean, usually I don't mind thunderstorms.
Well, that's a hell of a storm, right?
Yeah.
Your dad doesn't still have some of that really good brandy back behind the bar, does he?
I guess so.
Well, I don't mean to impose, but I could really use a stiff drink after being out in that shit. Hey, say, kid, want to join me for a stiff drink?
I don't know. My dad always gets on to me when I sneak that shit from the bar. I can always tell.
I won't tell anybody if you won't. David, this is Barry. I'm at the house, so I will see you in just a few minutes. Thanks. He has got to still be at the opera. All right, post time, kid. Come on.
You do know I'm underage, right?
I know you drink, Morgan. I used to watch you all the time at your father's cocktail parties when you were like 15?
You watched me.
Yeah. You used to always sneak in and steal all those wine coolers that nobody else wanted.
Guess I wasn't too sneaky about it. Can I get some ice or something for this?
Hey, you gotta be kidding me. That's no way to drink brandy. Come on now.
I know how to drink brandy.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a pro over here. I always thought it was cute how you used to always dip into our punch bowl, too.
You thought it was cute?
Yeah.
You sure used to watch me an awful lot, didn't you?
Yeah. I mean, never in a weird way. Just, I was just perceptive.
Yeah.
Sure. You were a cute little thing back then, too.
Oh, whatever. Back then, I was a pudgy little hose bag who wore way too much eyeliner.
Nuh-uh. I don't think that. I don't think that at all. Come on. Get you another drink before your dad gets in trouble.
Do you, like, get off on encouraging minors or something?
Would you believe you're the third one this week?
I know one thing. I will not need to be wasted when my dad gets here. That's the last thing I need. Doing.
You have another shirt I can borrow?
I mean, I'm sure my dad does. That's upstairs. Fuck that shit.
If any of this is making you uncomfortable in any way, just let me know. Come on, Morgan. We're just two people. Having a casual conversation over a harmless little drink.
It's been a while since I've had brandy. I should probably pace myself.
Nonsense. You're only young once. Come on, kiddo. Toss it back, rookie. You know what to do. Dip into the punch bowl, Morgan. Attic.
Speaking of dipping into the punch bowl, wasn't it you that used to screw around with bread?
What do you mean, screw around?
Seems like I can remember seeing you two at the same type of parties you guys would see me. You guys would always sneak around and make out and shit the same way I would sneak those wine coolers.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah. Yeah, and my dad would always be really busy with clients, but I can remember you two getting pretty friendly with each other now that I think about it.
Got some wild imagination, kid, that's all I can say.
You know, I don't even know if my dad knew about that. I bet you didn't even know that I knew.
Morgan, what you're saying right now has got to be the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. What in God's name makes you think that I've been getting frisky with your father's girlfriend?
Because I watched you two. Not in like a weird way or anything. I was just being intercepted. Come on, Barry. We're just two people having a casual conversation over a harmless little drink, right? Seriously, dude, you can be honest with me. I don't give a shit. That's y'all's business. I do have to admit that's typical Brynn for you, though. Everything you know about that shady bitch. I'm just curious. Dip into the punch bowl, Barry.
I'm getting things ready.
Getting things ready for what?
When your daddy gets home.
Oh. It was you, wasn't it?
Me what?
You who kept calling me?
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, Morgan. Don't cry, baby. This ain't about what I want from you. This is about what you're gonna do for me. Do you know what this is, Morgan? This is a little something I like to call income tax.
What is that? What does it do?
Oh, it's just gonna make you feel really good. And by the time it's done doing what it's supposed to, you won't know what hit you. And I'm gonna be making love to you the second you die. And your last breath's gonna go into me. And you'll be mine forever.
Sticking me with that thing.
This ain't the only thing I'm sticking you with. Besides, I gotta make it look for real when your dad comes walking through that door, don't I?
What the hell are you talking about?
No offense. But given the number of times you've been into and out of rehab, I don't think walking through that door and finding you dead in this chair with this sticking out of your arms is gonna be too big of a shocker, if you catch what I'm saying.
Just let me fuck. You're not gonna get away with this.
When you let me in that door, I kinda got away with it. and I've planned this out to perfection.
Look. If this is about money, I know I can talk to my dad as soon as he gets home, okay?
I can't do that. Because I gotta be done with you and out of here before your daddy even leaves that opera.
Barry, listen. I know you don't want to do this.
Morgan, I'm getting paid a lot of money to do this. But I need you to understand something. Even if I weren't, I really, really want to do this. But what I want to do right now is suck on that fucking tongue of yours. Have you ever kissed a man before? Have you ever kissed a man before? Well, that's really fucking good, because if you don't do that this next time, I'm gonna put this needle in your goddamn eye. You got that? Is there any part of that you don't understand?
Something okay.
As much as I'd love to work something out with you, I've got business to attend to.
Well, look, no, we can talk about this.
We've wasted enough time.
I have to go pee. If you'll just let me out of this chair.
You can piss yourself for all I care.
Look, I'll let you watch me while I go. Let me go to the bathroom, please.
What did you say to me?
I said you could watch me go if you want. I know you like me. I know for a fact you think I'm pretty.
Aren't you a naughty girl?
Let me go to the bathroom, okay? Just let me go to the bathroom. I'll pee for you.
Let's do this, bitch.
Morgan, where are your clothes? Hey, I'm talking here, young lady. Look at me. Why in God's name are you half naked right now? He's here, isn't he? That fucking Robbie is in there, and that's what the hell you've been up to.
It's not Robbie, it's Barry. Barry Cohn just tried to murder me.
Barry Cohn, wait, Morgan, what are you talking about?
He's in the bathroom, I can show you.
Show me what exactly?
That Barry Cohn literally just tried to rape and murder me, and that this duplicitous bitch was in on it.
Morgan, you're being delusional.
Fuck you and everybody that looks like you, Bryn. You haven't liked me from the start.
That is not true.
Bullshit. You're trying to get me out of the picture so you can get half of my dad's money. I know you.
Morgan!
That is ridiculous.
I know what's up, you British piece of shit. I'm on to you.
All right, stop this. Now I want you to can it with that shit and apologize to Bryn right now.
I'm not apologizing to her. She's been plotting against me.
Honestly, David, her behavior is unconscionable.
Sweetheart, what are you on right now?
I wish the fuck I was on something. Just come with me to the bathroom and I'll show you, Daddy. I'm not crazy.
Morgan, is this what you wanted to show me? You haven't learned one goddamn thing yet, have you?
What? I swear to God, he was right here on the floor. So are my clothes.
And just what the hell were your clothes doing in the middle of the bathroom floor in the first place, Missy?
He made me take them off. And he tried to take his off too, and that's when I cut him and ran.
You cut him and ran? That's it. That's it. You're going back to rehab, and that's final. I swear I cannot trust you to be by yourself alone in this house for 5 minutes.
Daddy, you're not listening to me. He was here in the house. He's still here.
Who's still in the house? Robbie?
No, it's not Robbie.
Robbie, goddammit, if you can hear me, you little asshole, I want you out of my house right fucking now.
Daddy, it's Barry. That's what I've been trying to tell you. Did he not call you?
Sweetheart, nobody has called me, all right?
He probably called her phone.
And seeing as how she and him set this whole fucking thing up.
Morgan, darling, you're not making sense of any of this.
Don't give me that shit. You've been fucking Barry Cohn. I know you have.
I haven't a clue what you're talking about.
How much were you paying him, Bryn? What was his cut gonna be?
His cut?
All right, quiet. The both of you. Cover up, for God's sake.
Daddy. He's still in here. I know that he is.
That's enough. Look, I need to have a word with Bryn in private. And I want you to go up to your room and wait for me. I'll deal with you in a minute.
I'm not going up there. Would you just listen to me for once?
For once, just do what I told you. Go to your room.
No!
Listen, girlie, you're already in a lot of trouble with me. I don't think you want me to start adding to your list of problems. What was she talking about in there?
Do you honestly think I have the slightest clue?
Well, tell me. Why did she just say you were fucking Barry Cohn?
Oh, come on. Surely you don't believe a word of that.
At this point, I don't know what to believe, Bryn. I don't know what's real and what isn't.
Look, David, your daughter needs serious professional help. She's always attempted to sabotage our relationship.
We're not talking about Morgan right now, all right? We're talking about you and Barry Cohn.
There's absolutely nothing to talk about.
Is there not? Are you sure about that?
David, I'm positive. Why on earth would I go to bed with Barry?
Come on, Bryn. I've seen you flirt with him plenty of times. And you have slept around on me before.
Yes, not with one of your colleagues of 15 years. That's preposterous. And for your information, you've slept around on me in the past just as many times, if not more.
That's not the issue right now. The issue is you and Barry Cohn and how my daughter seems to know every nook and cranny about it.
I hate to break it to you, Jim. The only thing your daughter knows is whatever she believes to be true. She's a spoiled
full of bitch crap, lives in her own feeble mind.
Stop changing the subject, Bryn. Did you or did you not fuck Barry Cohn?
Stop grilling me. Not going to answer that question.
Why? Because it's true?
No, because it's absurd. As many stories as your daughter's fabricated about me, you actually believe I'm fooling around on you.
I pray to God you're not, Bryn. Because if I find out you've been cheating on me with him, of all people, you're not gonna like how I react to it.
What is that supposed to mean?
Just what I said, sweetheart. It better not be true.
Or what, David? Suppose you found out it were true. What would you do? Would you ground me, like you did your daughter? Would you punish me, like a naughty little girl? Would you spank me, the way you do her, David?
Is it true?
That's it, David. Do it again, but do it much, much harder this time. That's what I want. I love it, David.
Stop playing games, Bryn. God damn it! Did you fuck Barry? Tell me you didn't!
Thank you.
Morgan, we need to get help fast. Well, don't just stand there. Help me. We need to call the police. Oh, God. Why are you looking at me like that? What did you do? What? You don't think I did this? Morgan, you must listen to me. Morgan, wait!
Thank you. little sow. I can smell you down here. Little bitch! Open the fucking door. I'll murder you like I did your mother.
What are you talking about?
Well, I guess the cat's out of the bag now, isn't it?
What did you do to my mother?
Let's just say I managed to slip a little something in her wine glass. Your mother was always so drunk and pathetic. Making it look like she drowned, that was the easy part.
Fucking bitch!
You're quite right, sweetie. I am a fucking bitch. And when someone stands in my way, I get rid of them fast.
Please. Why are you doing this?
It's about money, honey. Pure and simple. The kind of money that's kept you in diamond nipple rings and silver panties your whole life.
Fuck you! I fucking hate you!
Of course you do. You have from the very start. Your mommy is my own rotten daughter. She's a spoiled and grateful little shit just like you. Now open this fucking door! Happen to be going to your grandma's, would you? You're making this too easy on me, Morgan. Fucking fuck.
Thank you. hello to your mother. The harlot is gone.
Ma? Something's wrong. I don't feel right.
My body feels like an imposter. My head is a void. Mother, love me.
Ah!
going on?
Thank you.